Howdy y'all, Butcherman back with some Farming Simulator 15 on Dayhouse Farm. Like I told you guys last time, we're going to be working on Field 15 here, which is the new field we just bought. And then hopefully while we're doing that, we're going to fertilize it and we're going to seed it with, I believe, canola. And hopefully while we're doing that, field number 3 up there that has canola in it already, it's about done growing, so we'll kind of hope that it finishes growing while we're working on this field. That way we can go ahead and just do that. The plan is to, you know, work on this field and then go and harvest that field. So how are you guys doing today? Anything exciting happen for you? I know I was working away, you know, just hanging out, doing my job and whatnot. And then about lunchtime, my wife texts me and says they're cutting the tree down. And of course I text her back and I said, "What tree are you talking about?" And she's like, "The tree in the front." And, you know, I immediately remember that probably like 8 months ago, I called the electric company down where I live. And basically what they do is if you call them and say, "Hey, there's this tree, blah, blah, blah. You know, I want to cut it down, but, you know, can you guys do it?" And they'll come out and look at it. And if it's close enough to the power lines, that it would hit the power lines if you cut it down, then basically what they'll do is they'll come out and cut it down for free, which is a great service, because it costs like $200 to $300 minimum probably to have somebody, hire somebody to come out and cut it down. I'd like to be able to do it myself, but of course the tree is like, you know, close enough to the house, it's close enough to the garage, it's close enough to the power lines, obviously, that if I try to do it, like, you know, basically they use a bucket truck and they sit there and piece it. You know, take it apart piece by piece and whatnot, and take the limbs off one at a time and all that stuff. Which is great that they finally came and did it, but basically that meant like as soon as I got home, that's pretty much what I did right away. Is I got my chainsaw out and a wheelbarrow and I just started like going to town on it. They're not completely done with it. I guess they're coming back tomorrow to completely fall the tree. For now, all they've done is they cut a bunch of limbs and stuff off of it. But yeah, I spent like about 3 hours after work doing nothing but, you know, cutting with a chainsaw and, you know, hauling some wood back to the back and like stacking it. It's green right now, so I can't really burn it in the stove, but, you know, it'll be dried by next winter and then I can go ahead and burn it then. So, you know, and it was an awful big tree, I'll tell you. Even the guys that came and cut it down, it's what you call a sweet gum tree, which is primarily the reason I wanted it cut down. If you don't know what a sweet gum tree is, it's basically one that produces gum balls, which are these little prickly balls that just, they're really irritating. I don't necessarily know what they're made of. It's like they're made of just steel, because you can't really cut them up with a mower. You know, it's actually a pain to even try to burn them. If you try to, like, throw them in your fire pit or whatever, you know, you can have trouble burning them. I mean, they're, like, almost invincible, these things. So to have them falling all over my driveway, all over my front yard, and all over our vehicles and all that stuff, it's just, I couldn't handle it. You know, I just bought the house in January, and, of course, these things are everywhere. So I called them and asked them if they'd come cut it down, and the guy got here, he's like, "That's the biggest sweet gum tree I've ever seen." It's like, yep, and it's a huge pain. So please cut it down for me. No, no big deal. But yeah, they cut it down for us, which is great. Like I said, they still gotta come back tomorrow and completely fall it. But you know, they cut down enough that even in 3 hours of me like cutting it up with a chainsaw, I couldn't actually get it completely done yet. Got our planter. I think, yeah, like I said, I think we're just going to plant some canola. It's the only canola we have is that stuff we're about to harvest. Didn't really do a very good job on this field. I'm not going to be able to plant all the way out to the edge of it. I usually have to take it all the way to the edge. See? Yep. Already hit the bushes. In that tree. I'm not gonna have to fold that up. kind of a pain. I'm gonna have to get the chainsaw and cut that tree down at some point. I didn't get it coming in. I get pulled out of it. Oh, there we go. That's kind of a pain. Well, I guess we'll kind of do what we do mowing. Just kind of like, oop. What's this thing doing? Feeling like all jittery and stuff. I don't know if it was the time it messed up. I really hope it's not messing up again. I really don't want to go through my mods list again and figure out why it's messing up. That's a really big pain. I think we'll just kind of stay away from it. We'll have to be able to just, you know, go over it. Maybe at some point we'll get in here and we'll like, basically go as close as we can to the edge or something. And, you know, maybe plant grass. But you gotta keep in mind whenever you bring the combine out here, you gotta have the combine get all the way out to the edge, otherwise you're gonna end up with an extra verge. Yeah, the turning radius in this thing is terrible. I don't think I have anything to do with the cedar. The cedar is really not big enough that it would affect this tractor as far as weight. And like, there's no weight on the tractor per se. As far as the cedar goes, it's got those little wheels that hold the tongue of it up even. This thing just has terrible turning radius. I think I'm looking for it, but we'll just not have one of these matches. Mainly the reason I have this is if I look through my mods list right now, these are actually free. I don't know why, I didn't really edit it or nothing like that. It's just I downloaded it because I like Massey's and whatnot. I love this tractor, but the fact that it's free kind of a little bit of a put off. I suppose I could go into the file and actually edit it to where it actually costs money. It costs whatever amount. But, when I got this one, I hadn't done that. I didn't even know it was free, to be honest. So, I don't know. I'm a little tired, actually. You know, I might as well at least, you know, get on here and, you know, do a video that I can put it out and, you know, work a little more on building my channel. And honestly, today I was actually thinking about maybe changing it to, instead of doing a video every single day, maybe just doing like certain days of the week where I do a video. But, you know, it's one of those things that it's just like, you know, if I want the channel to grow, I'm going to have to do the work. You know, so I guess for a while we'll probably do one video a day. I'll try that. I don't know if I'll actually accomplish that because, you know, I normally always have a lot of stuff going on for the most part. You know, it's not even just like last video or two videos ago, I think I was talking about, you know, health issues and stuff, but just for the most part I have a lot of stuff to do. I normally try to keep pretty busy. Sometimes, like, there's, you know, obviously there's some days that I'll just spend hours and hours on the computer. But then there's other days that I may not get on at all because I just have so much stuff to do. And then once I get done, you know, with everything I have to do, you know, I'm so tired that I just, you know, I might just sit down and watch TV and then I'll just go to bed. I just can't handle the, excuse me, the getting on here and actually doing stuff. But I do really love playing this. I normally, even sometimes when I'm tired, I'll get on here and actually do, you know, a bit of this and a bit of that, you know, not a whole lot of stuff. Just because, you know, playing Farm Sim is kind of like a stress reliever for me. It really helps me out most of the time. I think what we'll do is we'll knock out three headlands and I'll start going back. I guess I could turn on GPS, but I don't know if I'll do that. If it's not that big, I don't know if I'll ever need GPS in this map. The fields are just so small. It'd be nice if they were bigger, but honestly, it's really not that big of a deal. I'm thinking about what I might do is instead of just doing day house farm every day, like I said, you know, I might get boring for some people, and maybe they don't want to see the same farm every single day. What I might start doing is like just like a few days a week or something. I'll record like an hour. You know, the idea I had today is, I don't know what people think about it, but I have an ongoing, like a, basically my own personal save game or whatever on Shellington Extended. You know, and all I've done on there so far was harvesting. And I got on and I've just been harvesting one field after another, you know, just going crazy with the combine. So what I thought about doing is what, and I might end up doing it just because, you know, I think it'd go over pretty well, I think, is what I might end up doing is, like, maybe 3 days a week, whatever, I'll just record, like, an hour-long video. You know, I'll do a whole hour video of Shellington Extended, and to be honest, it probably won't even be, you know, it may not be a video as good as like I do on Day House, because I really try on this, on these videos. Like I try to do, you know, commentary the whole time, and I try to do, you know, make sure I'm continuously working or whatever, but I think if I was actually doing an hour-long video, I'd probably be able to work the whole time, because Shellington Extended is, it's a very big map. You know, there's always stuff to do on there. I think I've harvested all but like four of the fields that you start with, because when you start, all but like two of the fields you own, which I can't remember how many you own, it's probably, it's a lot though. All but two of them you own are already harvesting. You know, they're already harvest ready. But I've already, you know, fertilized everything, I've already planted the two that weren't planted, and I've already harvested all but like three or four of them. I think I'm working on field 17 at the moment. But like I was saying, what I might do is just end up doing like an hour-long video 3 days a week, something like that, just to kind of change it up and, you know, maybe get some people, like some of you people probably like to see, you know, the big, you know, the big equipment moving around, you know, using the big combines and all that stuff that we just won't get on this map because it's just too small. You know, I think this map is really good for doing a Let's Play. Because, you know, you can do a lot of, like, small personal content. You know, you can keep yourself busy as long as you just keep doing. Like, you can use all the small equipment. You're not limited to just using the big equipment. It's like those maps like Shellington, you know, if you're not using the biggest equipment on the game, you're going to be taking forever. You know, you'll spend 5 hours on one field doing something. But like this map, you can use the smallest equipment and, you know, still take a little while. But I think this one just works really well if you're trying to do like 30-minute videos or whatever. You know, I don't know how it'll go over doing, you know, trying to do an hour-long video. You know, I don't know how well people like to watch, you know, an hour-long video. And to be honest, it wouldn't even be all, you know, basically if I start doing that, like I was saying, it won't be quite as good as this. Like, you won't see everything I do, you know, on there. Because there'll probably be a lot of times that I work on there and I just don't record. That's one of the maps right now that I play on when I'm not recording. Because, like, this map, I try not to do very much at all without recording. You know, so that one would probably be just the map that I kind of just play on, whatever, and, every so often I record something, you know, record me doing a harvest, I record me doing, you know, working on the cows, or, you know, doing some planting or whatever. Most of the planting on that map I have Horseplay do it. I have Horseplay do the planting, I'll have them do the fertilizing. So far I've been doing all of the harvesting myself. Like, I run the harvester, and then I Horseplay an overloader into a trailer, you know, into a semi. And then the semi takes the grain back to the farm. I don't think I haven't sold any grain yet, but I have just tons, you know, lots and lots of it that I could sell and just get lots of equipment probably. That'll probably be one of those maps that I just absolutely wait for a great demand. And then, you know, if you do that and you just have like a million pounds or like a million meters or whatever it is, then you'll make a killing off of it. You just have so much of it. And what I've been trying to do is just kind of get a lot of everything. You know, obviously when you start, you have a lot of wheat and you have a lot of barley. Not very much canola. I don't think I've even harvested canola at all. You don't start with any canola fields that I remember. If you do, just correct me or whatever. But yeah, that's kind of like the idea that I've had. I don't know if I'll do it, because I don't know what people would think about an hour-long video, or you know, even just a video on a map that I'm not recording everything. You know, I think there's at least a couple of people watching this series. You know, I don't know who or, you know, whatever, that I haven't got any comments or nothing on, you know, hey, you're doing a great job, or you need to do this, or I might see this, or whatever. So I'm just, at the moment, I'm just kind of doing it and trying to build my channel and trying to make a little bit, you know, make a little bit of content and just kind of see what people think and whatnot. You know, if you have any suggestions at all, just, you know, shoot over to me. I don't know what, you know, obviously, any YouTuber, you never know what people want to watch until they tell you. You know, like I actually watch Daggerwind's video and whatnot, and like this video from today, you know, today is Wednesday, the video from today was, you know, they said, well, people want to see me, you know, mow the verges, you know, like the edge of the road and the edge of the field and whatever, so he went and found a mod that he can, you know, it's basically a hydraulic side cutter, if that's what you want to call it. I don't know what the exact name for it is. I'd call it a side cutter. Hydraulic arm side cutter mower. And so that's what he was doing. I haven't watched the whole thing yet. I'm trying to record this video while my wife's cooking dinner. Because now she's getting in the habit of, like, when she comes home. Today she came home and she's like, hey, did you record a video yet? I said, no. You know, I was working on the tree outside. She's like, oh yeah, you know, that's right. Yeah. I'm gonna try to go record a video while you're doing the dinner, while you're cooking dinner, and then hopefully I can at least get it recorded, and then, you know, I'll have Windows Movie Maker get, you know, prepping there or whatever while I'm eating. So, you know, that's weird. Like, I should have collided with that before this tractor. Like I've talked about before, this tractor's collision points are a little weird. It's like, almost, sometimes it's almost like the very center of the tractor's only thing it has a collision. But I like it, you know. Definitely a nice tractor. We'll swing this over here real quick and we'll fill it up. That way we don't forget. And then we'll take a look at our menu. Where's the... Now we're going to the seat over there. We're going to park the seat here, obviously. And then we'll look at our menu real quick. And we're going to see if Field 3 up there's grown yet or not. If it has, then we'll start moving some equipment up here. Let's see. It has not grown. So what I'll probably do is I'll do a bit of a fast forward. I do want to, you know, harvest that field in this video. I'll do a bit of a fast forward and then I'll be back when the field is ready to harvest. And we're back. And we're in the combine. And the field is ready. I'm not sure how far I fast-forwarded it, but I'm sure it's probably a couple hours. I don't know how well this will work. I do have the header trailer hooked onto the back of this because it is, you know, able to do that. So we'll kind of see how this goes. Hopefully the header doesn't fall off. I know this map is a little bit, you know, it's a very tight map. And I think the header's sticking off a little bit on that side, but that's okay. We'll get her figured out. Turn our beacons on. Get our headlights going. We got more headlights? No, that's it. Okay. I think we'll make it. It's fine. Get our combine up there. We'll go ahead and combine the field. You know, we'll harvest it. We'll put it in the trailer. And then that'll probably be it. We might move the equipment back, or I might do that off camera, I don't know. It kind of depends on, you know, how long the video's been going and whatnot, but most likely what I'll do is I'll just kind of run the combine through the field and I'll pick it all up, and it should all fit in here, I think, but I'll run it through the field and pick up the canola and I'll put it in the trailer. As you can see, I already got the trailer up there, if you can see it right there. Little Lamborghini tractor with my little tipper trailer. This is a small equipment, but for this map, it actually works really well. You know, I do like using course play a lot, but course play just, you know, it's not going to work on this map very well, just because it's, you know, the map is so tight. You know, I'll probably be able to do a little bit, you know, like once I get an overloader and stuff, I'll probably be able to do some of these fields, like, you know, some of the bigger ones, like this field here. I'll be able to park the semi right here, the tipper trailer right here, and I'll be able to just overload into it, and then it'll take it back to the farm and then come back. So it should work out. We'll just kind of pull over here like this. I never even noticed that. There's a beacon on the trailer right there. That's pretty cool. Turn those off since we're on private property at the moment. What are we looking at? Oh, there we go. Alright. Let's get this here combined. Oh, well, I'm gonna unfold it first. We got that. That'll raise up there. Back to the cap. Now it'll let me. There we go. And I'm already stuck in the bush. This field looks a lot like the one we were just working on. Plantings, you know, surface or planting areas right up next to the bushes. It's not quite as bad, I don't think, but, you know, it needs to be a little ways away. That way you have a little bit more room to kind of swing your cedar around and stuff. You know, but that's just little things. You know, little things that could be changed. Another thing I was thinking about maybe for the channel is, I know I did a review video for Newbie Farm, which seems to be getting, you know, about as many views as my day house stuff. So what I was kind of wondering is, you know, would people like to see, you know, me actually do a Let's Play on Newbie Farm? I don't think the guys come out with an update that has, like, beef and, you know, the beef and pig mod actually correctly, you know, installed and all that. So I was thinking what I might be able to do is actually see if I can't contact the guy that made the map and, you know, ask him if he's gonna update it or if he has updated it, and maybe, you know, I'm just not able to find it or whatnot, but if I could actually get the actual, you know, up-to-date version maybe that has the pigs and the beef, then I would probably definitely be willing to do the map. You know, but then again, I mean, if he's not going to update, or if he just doesn't update it, whatever, I can still do a Let's Play. You know, if you guys actually want to see it, I can still do it. I don't think it'd be quite as good, but you could do everything else. You know, you could do everything but the pigs and the beef, and I think it would work out just fine. So, yeah, if you guys just want to kind of, like, comment on that and just, you know, let me know what you think. you'd like to see me go ahead and do a let's play on the newbie farm and, you know, do a bit of farming on there. I know it is a little difficult. I know starting out there on there would be a little difficult, so I would probably modify some of the starting stuff, like add some money to buy, you know, a few fields and whatnot, add a little bit more equipment. Because I do, you know, just like anybody, you really don't want to, you know, start out bare too many times, you know, because it's definitely a grind, you know. So doing this here grind, you know, with a little bit of equipment and whatnot, I do like it, but at the same time, it's just, it's a lot of work. You know, it's a lot of work. But, you know, it's kind of one of those things. If that's what you guys want to see, then that's probably what I'll just do. I can always do the grind. It's not that big of a deal. But doing two maps at the same time, it'll probably just be like 3 days of one map and 4 days of another map or something like that. Or maybe I'll have 1 day of the week or something like that where I do something else. You know, some other random thing, like, you know, maybe Euro Truck Simulator or whatever. That doesn't seem all that popular. I think I've had like a, you know, I've looked at my thing and basically the most popular video I've done so far is episode 1 on Day House. You know, and honestly it's weird because it says the average viewing time is actually longer than the actual length of the video. You know, so I don't really know how that works. You know, it says the average viewing time, I think it's like 33 minutes or something like that. But the video itself is only actually like 26 minutes maybe. So, but my Euro Truck Simulator videos, they've got a couple of views, but like on my end, when I look at my thing, you know, it'll tell me how long people have watched it, but it's got like 3 or 4 views, but basically people clicked on it, watched it for like a minute, and then decided, well, this is crap, I don't want to watch this. But yeah, Day House Farm on there, this is pretty much the only thing that people are actually watching. So yeah, this is what I'm playing, you know, this is what I'm doing just because, you know, this seems to be what people want to see. So until somebody says, hey, you know, this is what I want to see instead, or, you know, whatever, this is just kind of got what I got to go with, you know. Until somebody gets on here and says, hey, I want to see, you know, Euro Truck and, you know, do this or do that or whatever. We'll dump this in here and then we'll call it a day. And I'll probably go and take all this stuff back to the yard off camera. My wife actually did just come in and say, hey, you know, dinner's ready. And my timer looks at it. It's probably going to be about a 30-minute video, maybe 25 minutes, something like that, depending on how much I edit out. So, yeah, look at that. I'm going to turn the headlights off. That's a pretty good one right there, I think. Look at that, guys. That's probably going to be the screenshot right there. That'll be the cover of the video. That's a beautiful picture. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think. Like, dislike, you know, subscribe if you want to. No big deal. But, yeah, let me know. This is the Butcher Man signing off.